Why should LSD be considered as medicine? Imagine going to your doctor and getting prescribed a week's dosage of LSD. Can this ever happen? After all, LSD is a banned drug, right? Well, recent research into the benefits of the drug has thrown up startling results. Scientists and experts have seriously begun contemplating the usage of the drug for the pharmaceutical requirements of human beings. Why were these LSDs banned? And most importantly, why should LSD be considered as medicine? Let's find out. Lysergic acid diethylamide, made famous as LSD, is an extremely potent psychedelic drug. Its effects on humans include intensified and deep thoughts and emotions coupled with sensory perception. At higher doses, LSD can cause sensual confusion, like mental, visual, and auditory hallucinations. The mode of action of LSD remains unknown, although superficial research has hinted that its mode of action is related to increasing the glutamate amino acid release in the cerebral cortex, culminating in the excitation of this area. Certain effects, like dilated pupils, increased blood pressure, and body temperature, begin appearing within half an hour of the intake, although lasting up to 20 hours at a time. At extreme doses, it is capable of creating mystical experiences and ego dissolution. LSD was discovered by Swiss chemist Albert Hofmann on November 16, 1938, experimenting at the Sandoz laboratories in Basel, Switzerland. LSD is a hallucinogenic drug with unique psychedelic features, discovered 5 years later after the accidental ingestion of the drug by Hofmann himself. He would later remark that he had felt a wide range of emotions, from sexual perversions to criminal behavior, as well as alcoholism, while under its influence. Regular consumption of LSD would soar after the endorsements made by many figures like Aldous Huxley, Timothy Leary, and Al Hubbard, who began actively advocating the consumption of LSD. The use of LSD for the successful treatment of alcoholism happened during the 1950s and the early 60s. The method involved compressing years of psychotherapy experiences into a single, compact, robust, self-reflective session with the alcoholics that aided patients to achieve self-confidence and the willpower to develop beyond their alcohol addiction. LSD was also implemented for addressing trauma patients, while others applied it to model psychosis and to help decode schizophrenic chemical reactions in the brain. While certain tests gave exemplary results, LSD did not give a constant narrative, as it tended to have a much varied result in randomized controlled trials. So, why was this drug banned? The drug was believed to be extremely enticing, making it a potent substance for abuse. A summary labeled it a potentially dangerous substance provided its capacity of conjuring terrifying hallucinations. In the 1960s, LSD became synonymous with the hippie culture, further damaging its reputation in the medical world. These were supported by several reports showcasing details of accidents, mental breakdowns, criminal acts, murders, and suicides that were motivated by psychotic reactions to the drug. The company of Sandoz, which was the prime manufacturer of the drug, officially stopped its production and distribution in 1965 as psychotherapists abandoned its use on humans. All this culminated in the October 24, 1968 judgment by the United States government to ban the possession of LSD. This also boomeranged into the research world as all investments and research on the drug were pulled down. The final FDA-approved study of LSD was completed in 1980, while the legal and regulated psychiatric use of LSD preserved in Switzerland until 1993. The last few years have seen several notable people in the medical profession actively challenging the status quo. The new study is being conducted along the lines of addiction research and palliative care, although the foundations have remained unaltered since the 50s, when neuroscience was very much in its infancy. The brain areas affected by LSD were observed to be turned on or off, resulting in the appearance of varying levels of consciousness in humans. LSDs belong to a class called psychedelics, which are considered to be a subclass of hallucinogenic drugs, notable for their ability to trigger unique states of consciousness. Under these special stages, random and unexpected changes in mood and a different perception of the state of things and self could happen. They are also extremely potent, meaning one doesn't need anything beyond a few micrograms of drugs to kickstart hallucinations. How do they affect the human body? Despite over half a century's worth of research by chemists all across the globe, nobody can give any concrete results about it. However, with the dint of several studies that have been carried out and the intellect of people like Michael Pollan, the Knight Professor of Science and Environmental Journalism at the UC Berkeley Graduate School of Journalism, certain conclusions have been reached, which have pointed to the 5-HT2A receptor system as the way of action of psychedelics like LSD and psilocybin. Molecular research has proven that the LSD molecules have a similarity in appearance to the 5-HT substrate, which is commonly known as serotonin. Serotonin is an important neurotransmitter in the brain that plays an instrumental role in controlling an individual's mood and perception. An in vitro test has shown that serotonin, on coming into contact with the psychedelics, enjoys a greatly augmented activity. Groundbreaking research has time and again shown that despite the popular misconceptions surrounding the harmful impact LSD has on mental health of the abuser, as well as its destructive effects on the DNA, psychedelic drugs like LSD are comparatively much less addictive than other drugs that have been allowed to ravage the modern society, such as alcohol. More reports make shocking claims that no deaths in the history of mankind have ever been directly attributed to LSD abuse. While adverse effects, including the likes of anxiety and paranoia, have been recorded, the negatives are still way more modest than the death toll due to alcohol consumption per year. LSD, if made legal, can find a wide range of applications. The use of psychedelics, including LSD, has been documented to have drastically improved the state of mental health of people. It helps people peek into their inner selves, helping them understand the formatting of their minds in certain difficult situations. People ailing from mental health problems, including those suffering from depression due to deteriorating conditions of their lives, have been recorded to have reported great improvements in stabilizing their mindset and making way for a normal life. Patients on the road to recovery from life-threatening illnesses like cancer have exhibited dramatic and unprecedented improvements through the use of psychedelic drugs like LSD. While meditation and decreasing stress can give a person mental peace, LSD makes the process more easy and affordable for many who live in a very difficult and rigid life. With great knowledge comes great responsibility, and is very applicable to LSDs as well. While this substance can act as a wonder for many patients prophesied with a difficult road to recovery, it can also prove to be a problem if used uncontrollably for recreational purposes. A majority of experts and researchers have insisted on the administration of these psychedelics within a particular set or setting. It means that a patient must be in a correct, stable mindset with sufficiently strong mental health to be able to withstand the effects of the drug. A properly controlled physical and social environment has also been deemed crucial before embarking on an LSD experience. Even during the heydays of LSD usage, people were known to use LSD in groups or with the presence of an expert who could be a shaman to handle the side effects of the drug. Needless to say, LSD, even amongst experienced communities, has the reputation of going rogue. Despite all the data, the research on psychedelics is still believed to be in its premature stages. The reason was the long period of ban on its use and the taboo it was associated with. While the fight to bring LSD back to the pharmaceutical stores has already begun in the US, the backbone of these activities has been the people's decision to not get misled by rumors and misconceptions. This has culminated in certain states like Oregon presenting formal legislation to lift the infamous ban and legalize its use for research at least. Thus, the story of LSD is one of misconceptions and a contrasting assortment of pros and cons. The idea of LSD, whether positive or negative, varies with a person's personal experiences and expectations of the drug.